acute pain is, for instance, a broken arm, stepping on a thumbtack, pinching your finger in the door, something that happens and has a reason that you can easily identify. When you have chronic pain and the pain has started to take off and have a life of its own, it starts to affect you in different ways. Areas of the brain that are saying, shut pain down, aren't as active anymore. And areas within the spinal cord in the brain that say, feel this more intensely, are more lit up. And so even though the x-ray might get better after that broken arm, my arm may still feel broken because now it's gone underground. If I lean on a hot stove, or if I go and sprain my wrist, the message is protect me, you're being harmed. And all pain is explained in either terms of actual or potential harm. So it's trying to protect us. But if all that processing change has gone on, and now the pain's there, but the bone is healed, that message doesn't mean anything. It's just getting in my way. It's making me miserable, but it doesn't tell me anything that's useful to me. Medications work by hitting what we call receptors. Think of it as a key and a lock and a door, all right? If you go to the front door of your house, you've got a house key and you open it, you put it in the door and you turn it and you go in. That's like a medication for acute pain, like morphine, going to a morphine receptor and doing its job. When I describe the change between acute pain and chronic pain, the chemistry in the nervous system changes. And so now the locks that you need to open up have changed so that the morphine or a similar medication might be really strong when the lock is opened by that key. But over time, when things have become chronic and now somebody's changed the locks on you, using the same key isn't going to get you where you need to go.